course of life. To God be the glory, greater things that He is doing in our lives. I first of all want to thank God for yesterday, greater blessing, Elect Ladies Night. As many of you that were able to make it physically and also to join online for such a prophetic program, I believe that you were blessed. And I want to continue to encourage you to extend the blessing to others. Be an instrument, a vessel of a blessing to somebody else who was not part of it. I believe that our Christian lives should move from what God has done for me to what God is doing or has done through me and with me. That is far more greater. So I encourage you to do that. And I want to also thank God for His vessel that He used in the person of Lady Pastor Teophilia yesterday. The Lord richly bless you for availing yourself for God to use you the way that He did. The Lord continue to bless you and make you a blessing unto others. And you too, the Lord continue to bless you and make you a blessing unto others. That is what we are in this world for, not just to receive, but to give. The Lord said, I will bless you and I will make you a blessing. God richly bless you. And one more time, you are welcome to Beautiful Words of Life. It is still beautiful. I mean, though you see only me, but it is still beautiful. Hallelujah. God bless you. I want to also use this opportunity to introduce you to some of the materials, the books that God has blessed us with. By God's grace, our previous discussions on the Beautiful Words of Life, they came from one of the books, The Spirit-Filled Life, The Quest for Supremacy. And we enjoyed an amazing trip in this book. And I want to encourage you, if you want to stay on top of the stress, the chaos that is ravaging this world, this is one of the books that you need. The Spirit of God. It gives you supremacy, an upper hand. We are more than conquerors by the Spirit's power, by the Spirit's life. So I still recommend this book to you so that you will live the life that God wants you to live. And we also have What Meaneth This? Quest for Influence. One day maybe you will also come to that. But in the meantime, you can also request for this great book. And we also have Apostolic Emphasis. Keep it there. The message of Christ and His apostles. Christ Himself is the apostle. And with His apostles, the authoritative message He gave them, which must be preached and listened to and lived for all time by all Christians and all people. Apostolic Emphasis. Keep it there. So you can contact us for these faith-building materials and God-glorifying materials, and your life is going to be blessed. God richly bless you. Today's discussion will be centered on prophetic experience, that I may know Him beyond visions and predictions. That is where we are on now. And by the grace of God, we've done two of it, where we spoke about prophetic experience began. And then in prophetic experience in everyday life, how God meets us in our everyday life. Every day he has something for us. And because of that, we have to be sensitive so that we can discern and perceive his appointments that he has for us. We are still making progress. Hallelujah. The Lord is going to bless you mightily with his word. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you. We give you the praise for today's beautiful words of life. You have appointed a day like this for us. We are not dull at all. We are sensitive. We can see, we can perceive that you want to bless our lives, and we are ready for it. Even so, bless us, Lord. More of your beauty for everyone. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. God richly bless you. So today I'm coming to the subject in this book, Prophetic Experience, that I may know him beyond visions and predictions. I'm coming to the subject of that I may know him. The essence and height of prophetic experience. The chapters in this book are called experiences. Working with God is an experience. And we are now in chapter 2, or experience 2. And that is the essence and height of prophetic experience, that I may know him. The Lord made me write this book out of a burden he gave to me for, you know, prophetic ministry and prophetic things in our days. Even right now, you know, with all the events that are going on in the world, people want to find out. And if you don't take care, you can get bogged down with the needless details of dates and events and who is Antichrist and whatnot. But what is the essence of prophetic things? God's prophets, prophetic experiences, his prophetic word. What is the purpose of all these things? And that is what I summarize under the title of his book, that I may know him beyond visions and predictions. So you had an encounter. God showed you something. You are seeing world events. And so what? It's not for arguments, entertainment, debate. It's not an experience for the sake of it. No. But that we will know him. And by God's grace, we are going to find it out in the scriptures. That is the culmination of prophetic things. Our experiences, the prophets God sent. If God sent Jesus, the greatest prophet of all, because Moses said, a prophet like unto me shall the Lord your God raise. If God sent him, then what is the purpose for which he sent him? That is the issue. And it is that we may know him. We may know God. Yeah. And that is the subject matter of today's beautiful words of life. Lovely. That I may know him. Beautiful. Philippians chapter 3, verse 10. All the words of God are precious, but there are some beautiful aspects of his precious words. That line, that I may know him, is beautiful. Praise God. I pray that you come to know the Lord through this message. You see, people in the Bible were not strangers to prophetic experiences. God met them. And what was the purpose, the significance of meeting these people? That they will know him. We can take somebody like Abraham. What an experience he had. In one of his everyday lives, God met him and he said, get out of your father's house. He went on a faith journey that changed the world. But then the Bible tells us that this man was a friend of God. Now, what is friendship for? Intimacy. What is intimacy for? Knowledge. You are really intimate with somebody to the degree that you know the person. And that is the purpose, the ultimate purpose why the Lord called Abraham and engaged Abraham. The Bible says he was a friend of God. God told him his heart. He got to know God. And he lived closely with the Lord. That is the essence of prophetic experience. Abraham could tell us a lot of things that happened in his life with God. How angels came to him. The miracle birth of Isaac. I mean, supernatural experiences upon experiences. But what was God aiming at in giving this man these experiences? That ultimately Abraham will get to know him. So when we say in the Bible, the God of Abraham, and of course Isaac and Jacob, we are talking about somebody who knows God. You see, your name never comes into that kind of line if you don't know God. Yeah, the God of Abraham. I mean, somebody who knew God. And that is the height and the essence of prophetic experience. We can also talk of Moses by the burning bush. What a prophetic experience that was. If you go outside and you have that kind of experience, or you wake up in the night and your pillow is burning, what kind of interpretation are you going to make out of it? Are you just going to be going about talking about it? You make videos out of it? Will you take time to know why this? What is the meaning of this thing? And that is what we are talking about today. It is to ultimately lead you to God, to make you know God. Moses began to know God from that point. In fact, he knew the name of God that nobody in his generation knew. God told him, I am that I am. When you go to Egypt, tell them, I am has sent you. That is somebody who knew God. And the man Moses kept on having experiences upon experiences with the Lord. In fact, the Bible says he spoke face to face with God. But at a point in time, he prayed in Exodus that, show me your glory. I want to know you. I want to see you. If I've found favor in your sight, if you've given me experiences upon experiences, I was a fugitive. I ran away from Egypt. I was in the wilderness, tending sheep, flock, and then you picked me up. If I found that favor, nothing else will satisfy but to know you. I pray that you and I, that will be our passion, to know the Lord. Let's come to the New Testament. Somebody like the Samaritan woman, she met Jesus. What was the purpose of the meeting? I mean, Jesus told her right away about her marital situation. Very awesome. And sometimes when people think of prophecies and prophetic meetings, it's like that is the highest for them. I was told my name. I was told my age. Oh, he even mentioned my telephone number and all of it. Great. God knows everything about us. He can tell you the number of hairs on your head. Literally. God knows it. But the question is, so what? You see, if we don't carry on to know the Lord. We have just stopped midline in prophetic experiences. We have come short of the glory of the prophetic experience, which is to know the Lord. But thank God the Samaritan woman knew God. Out of that usual, you know, everyday experience, she used to come to the well to fetch water. And then this time around, she met Jesus. And then something was happening. And she realized suddenly, she knew that this is the Messiah, the Savior of the world. And her life was changed. She knew Jesus intimately. What a privilege. She could tell that this is the Savior of the world. The man Paul, who gave us that statement, that I may know him. Paul the Apostle, you know, he had an awesome encounter at Damascus Road. The Lord arrested him there by himself, and he heard his name. What an experience. Was it just to go home and write a book about it? And go talking from synagogue to synagogue about an experience I had? No. He knew that it was an experience for him to know God. And we are told that it is after walking with God for decades that this man still comes back to say that I may know him. He speaks of visions, revelations about the Lord, but he said, I'm not just having those things for the sake of having them. They are not the end in themselves. There is more to it. I want to know the Lord. And how a beautiful person you become when you get to know the Lord. If all you know is visions and dreams and prophetic experiences of all kinds, your life can still be ugly if you don't know the Lord. But it is when you know the Lord that there is a real difference in your life. Hallelujah. So prophetic experience is for intimacy, not entertainment. It is to know God. That is the ultimate. It's to know the Lord. John chapter 17, verse 3. The Bible says that, and this is life eternal, that we might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom you have sent. That is the essence of prophetic experience. All the prophets who came, they came to prophesy about Jesus. The Bible said they prophesied of the grace that should come to us. Also, that we'll be clapping. Wow, what prophets they are. Because when you look at the sharpness with which they prophesied into the distant future, then the accuracy, people like Isaiah, like David, and it came to pass. Now, God does not think that he made them to prophesy just to end it there. No, the purpose of the grace he gave them, the utterances he gave them, the visions, all the way from the Old Testament prophets to the last of them, John the Baptist, was so that we will know the Lord. We will know God. He says, this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom you have sent. That is the essence and the height of prophetic experience. It's not so that you will know an enemy. No. Life is more serious than that. You may know your enemy, but go beyond that. What is the point of Israel knowing the Egyptians and knowing the Philistines and knowing all their perennial enemies? You know, people used to come and fight them if they did not know God. As a matter of fact, their defense against those nations was even in their knowledge of God. Don't you remember David? When he was face to face with Goliath, it was the knowledge of God that brought the giants down. He said, "You have defied the God of the armies of Israel, but I come against you in his name. I know him, the Lord who delivered me. I had an experience when I was tending my father's sheep. He delivered me from the bear, from the lion. He will deliver you into my hands." And he did. If you get to know the Lord, some things are going to be delivered into your hands. Hallelujah. That is the height and the essence of prophetic experience. I want to take you to a scripture in Isaiah 11, verse 9. It says, "They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea." Now, this is a prophecy of Isaiah. And he's saying that they shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain. There will not be destruction, hurt. Why? Because the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. The ultimate in God making us to know him is so that we will not be destroyed. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Not just the experience. As for the experience, you may have it. For instance, going to school is an experience. But in the experience, did you have knowledge? If you didn't have, you can still end up on the streets. But it is when you had knowledge as you went to school, you had that experience that you live well in life. So he says, "The earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea." And that is the culmination of all prophetic things. When I say prophetic things, I mean the prophets themselves, God's prophets, the Old Testament prophets, their prophecies, and our prophetic experiences, because we are still in it. God is still encountering us. For instance, you are listening right now. What is the purpose? It's beyond admiration. Oh, I like this man who is talking. Great. But beyond that, God wants you to know him. Yes. That is the essence and height of all prophetic experience, the knowledge of God. Sometimes you can even go to a church because you say, "I love the pastor." It's great to love God's servant, but that could have been an attraction by the Lord, even though you may not have known, so that you will know him. That is the whole point. What is the knowledge of the Lord? It is the dealing of God's wisdom to you so that you will not perish and waste your life. That is why he says, "They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, because the earth is full of the knowledge of the Lord." The significance of the prophets God sent was so that we will not be destroyed. They came to bring us God's knowledge, God's counsel. They were God's spokesmen to discharge divine counsels and wisdom. Take the nation Israel, for instance. If they had obeyed God's counsel and wisdom from the prophets he sent them, they would have escaped some of the things that they went through. You see, the problem is not that you are not having an experience, but are you having knowledge out of that experience? God sent them prophets. They prophesied to them. Some of the prophets we wish we would have seen, but they did not hear. They did not receive the counsel. Therefore, they went into captivity. They had problems upon problems. And sometimes that is the same thing with us. We have God's people with us. We have gifts of God with us, yet you have an unresolved issue. And it's because that you have not come to know the Lord. He said, my people are destroyed. They are hurt because there is no knowledge. If they would have listened to the prophets, just like they were talking to them to do, they would have escaped a lot of the things that they went through. At a point, Ezekiel said unto the nation Israel, that why will you die, O house of Israel? We are talking to you, we are bringing you knowledge, but you seem not to get it. I pray for you that you will get to know the Lord. I'm not just talking about just any knowledge. There are all kinds of knowledge in the world, but I'm talking about the knowledge of God, knowing God, that I may know Him. Hallelujah. I want to end with the importance of this knowledge. Very important. Already I've harped on it, but I still want to talk more about it. The difference between this chaotic world presently and the world to come is that in the latter, the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the prophet said. That's the difference. That is how important the knowledge of the Lord is. The reason why there will be peace and no violence in the world to come is not because prayer warriors have multiplied themselves or there are a lot of security measures around. No, but because of the knowledge of God. We have known God. Paul said, then shall we know, even as I am known. Now, when that thing happens, it takes away all that destroys, all that hurts. But it's the fountain source of peace, the knowledge of the Lord. See, that is what we experience when Jesus comes. His knowledge will be everywhere. We know the Lord. And all strife and confusion and everything cease. But even before then, we can know the Lord now. We can know the Lord for our lives, for our families, for our relationships, and then we will enjoy peace. We will not hurt nor be destroyed. Our families will be at peace. Our nation will be at peace. The way to have peace in our nation is by the knowledge of the Lord. It's not to multiply security forces and more policies. No. But when the hearts of men become a citadel of the knowledge of God, there will be peace everywhere. Hallelujah. I want to pray with you as we bring this episode to a close. And I want to pray that God will give you a passion to know Him. Yes. Have experiences, have dreams, have visions, whatever. Go for meetings, go to church, buy books, listen to programs. But ultimately, it is to know God, that I may know Him. So, Father, I thank you for everyone who has heard us today. I pray that the desire to know you will fall on them and will increase in them. Yes, Lord. That is the way out of hurts and destruction when we are filled with the knowledge of God, that we will know you. We thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. Amen. God, which will bless you. And we are going to come to you again next week. Keep knowing the Lord. The Bible says, then shall we know if we follow on to know the Lord. Let the week we are entering in be a deliberate one of knowing God. You make up your mind, I'm going to know the Lord. I'm not just looking for somebody to tell me something, but I want to know God for myself. Amen. Until I see you again, it is think beautiful, talk beautiful, and live beautiful. God richly bless you. How glorious, how beautiful.